ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Two Fat Guys Talking Flowers, where we're always going to give you the good, the bad, the ugly about flowers. I'm Fern, here with Joelle. We got Mimi in the house, Ryan right next to me, Mike is on the other side, and our awesome, star-studded, dynamic duel of a guest today is none other than Batman and Superman, a.k.a. David Marine and J.D. Lucona, the director of Deliflor, David, the commercial and marketing director, J.D., from Deliflor.
Woo! Woo! Welcome, guys.
You left out the award-winning.
Award-winning.
That's right.
Yeah.
This is my favorite picture.
It's Superman and Batman.
Which one's
dynamic
which?
Duel.
This is my favorite picture of 2023 for the floral industry is these two guys with all these awards. That's so badass.
That is a great picture.
What an introduction. Thank you very much.
It's like those movie stars that win in every category.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're nominated for everything.
Yeah. Thank you.
Not only nominated, though.
so humble.
Well, you know what? He should be. These guys are making waves. They're changing the game.
Well, actually, we are good followers. So just looking to your company, that's what gives us inspiration. So.
Oh, thank you. That's a beautiful thing to hear. But I think it's a little tit for tat there because you guys are really coming up with some awesome varieties. You came up, I think, with three new categories?
Three new categories, but between these three new categories, we got around 25 varieties. I mean, different varieties.
Wow.
And in one of those categories, we're testing 60 codes right now. So yeah, next year is going to be, this year, we're going to start introducing them into the industry. And I think 2025, we're going to come with about 80 new varieties.
Wow.
Exactly. This week, we're having 20 new varieties.
Wow,
here
you
in
ain't
Miami.
Seen nothing yet, guys. Damn.
Yeah. No, well, it's constant work. And because we go to the field every day, we see, okay, I like this. And maybe David says, I like it too. But maybe the agronomist didn't like it. But we push it to, let's try it, let's see it, because, it has to be a joint venture between the agronomist and us in order to get the best commercial look and a variety that works on the field, and it's easy to grow.
So how long, and I know we got a lot to talk about today, but I'm just curious, you're bringing 80 new varieties. How long did it take you to get those 80 varieties to where you feel commercial about them?
It's around 4 years, 3 years. Now we're doing a bit fast because we're working with molecular markers, which allowed us to develop the varieties a bit faster. But it takes around 4 or 5 years. And every year we have around 30 new varieties.
Deliflor started when? Because I remember the Deli Star Mum, which was their first big hit. When I was a kid.
Deliflor in Colombia started 25 years ago, more or less. Yeah. And it's a nice story because my father started the company at that time with the Dutch guys.
In
Colombia, yes. But yeah. Deliflor in Holland, I think it's going to be 45 years.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So our mother house, it's Deliflor, but it's owned by this bigger group that is called the Baking Camp Group. So when they started breeding chrysanthemums, because it's only chrysanthemums, it's the second largest crop in the world being grown. So when they started there, they said, okay, they were sending the seeds here, to Colombia and Ecuador to see what's good for those parts. And before, 24 years ago, we were only just their office in Colombia. But now it's different. Now it's a different company. Now we're Deliflor Americas. And we work separate from them because most of the varieties that they have in Holland doesn't work in Colombia and vice versa. So what we're doing is just, as you said, we kind of changed the game 10 or 15 years ago when we started to promote our varieties to our, not to our primary customer, but
Who started Chrysanthemum Week? Was that you guys that started
it? Yeah, we started.
And then everybody else joined in?
Yeah, so we started to do our open house on week 35th.
So all the growers from South America come
And at that time, we joined forces with another two breeders.
With Doomin,
With Doomin Orange at that time. And every year, it's getting bigger and bigger. Last year, we had like 1,000 people in our greenhouse during that week.
So how does that work? You send out invites to your customers to come to the testing areas?
So to all our customers, we invite them with an appointment any day. But we're bringing people from Bogota, or our farms from Bogota, and everybody from Ecuador.
So you're sending the corporate jet to go pick them up in Bogota and bring them to Medellin?
We're getting there. but we also invite people from the United States, customers of our customers at supermarket.
Isn't that a problem when you invite supermarkets to the growers? Because I know I've heard some stories that the supermarket wants shit, but it doesn't really work.
Because 5 years ago I was in this panel for breeders and for IFPA, and it was all the owners of the big companies. And I was telling the supermarkets were there. I was telling the supermarkets, reach to us. If you want to see what's new, reach to breeder. And, you know, the owners of the farms don't like that because some of them prefer.
Yeah, because the owners of the farm want to grow shit that makes them money, not necessarily what the supermarket
but
just likes.
But if you're honest to the supermarkets, the things works well. But if you start telling just bullshit, you can have this variety for tomorrow or 3 months or 1 month, things goes wrong.
Yeah.
But if they understand it takes time, you develop the variety with all the things you need to test, the vase life, the pest, that kind of things, supermarkets understand that they can have the variety in 8 months or a year.
Yeah, but they need to understand that kind of things. You're educating the supermarket buyer about the growing and breeding process.
Okay, so that makes sense.
Sense, because if somebody just comes in and says, I like that, I want it, just give me 7 million of them.
Yeah, it's been, it was like that before. And so they said a new variety, they didn't even have a name. They were, we need this for the next Christmas. That's impossible. And now, as David told you, that we're working with molecular markers, we have the molecular markers to
explain
see
that.
Yeah, I have no idea what that means.
So
I watched a lot of Star Trek, and I don't know what a molecular marker is.
Beam us in, JD.
You can create variety in two ways. The one way is doing the crosses and develop a variety only with the physical characteristics.
The phenotypics,
with the color, with the shape, with the size, with the nice foliage. But you can do it also with more science, just with pest resistant, more sustainable variety, because you need to apply less chemicals. So we do both. And in the other way, with more science, with the molecular markers, you can do it faster, and you can cross the variety with a better vase life, or cross the variety
you can
which
almost
needs less chemicals.
You can almost put in what you want.
No, we don't want that. We don't want that because that's transgenic. We just do what the bee does. So what we do is we cross our varieties just like if we were a bee, just put some pollen in another one and get seedlings and then test them for 5 years.
Wow, that's a lot of work.
That is crazy.
And they go status by status. But now, if we got a nice variety, let's say Alma, and we have Alma. And we know.
Cha-ching. Exactly. You got to put the cash register noise whenever he says Alma.
Exactly. So let's say we know this variety is perfect because it lasts 25 days in the vase. And there is a molecular marker that tells us that. So every time we see that molecular marker in the same position in another variety, we know it's going to last 20 days. And right now
it tags it.
And right now we got molecular markers for fungi,
no comprende,
disease. And it's a... I mean, the DNA...
I'm totally geeking out on this. That is fucking cool.
And this is the only thing I know about DNA. So the DNA, it goes from four letters that it shows with light on the microscope. And you see ACTG. And if you see, five letters that are the same on the same position, you already know that it's resistant to white rust or resistant to fungi. So that's...
That is crazy.
And that saves us, 3 years of testing. So
you're able to speed it up on a scientific way.
Yeah. So we don't have to test those 3 years because we already know that the variety tends or the variety is resistant to white rust or whatever.
So we have been teaching to the supermarkets what we do and what they can do, because normally supermarkets just see a chrysanthemum like a white cushion or white daisy or white spider. And before, they didn't know the varieties we have. We have now like 600 commercial varieties.
Wow.
And the people only know 10, 5, 20, I don't know.
I mean, you got to sample them, you got to sell them, you got to show them, because I guess that is the staple of the chrysanthemum business is supermarkets. But I also see it as a pain in the ass. I was like...
Actually, it's so easy. It's so easy because you're not selling anything to anybody.
If I was a bouquet maker in Colombia and the supermarket was telling me what to grow specifically...
You're not the boss of me.
I'd have a problem with that.
But Mike, that also happens with like anything that you have to add on with the sleeves, with the flower food. The supermarkets, they almost demand this to the growers, and the growers have a lot of resistance. And then that's when they start going against it. But when you're talking about the actual variety, there's no way to go around it.
Yeah.
You know?
I guess. I'm just old school with that stuff. I just feel like everyone has their place. And I feel like the bouquet company has world-renowned designers coming in from all over the world to choose varieties and to make recipes that are going to sell 2 years from now.
Yeah, but you know that all the flower companies, they don't only sell to one supermarket. Yeah. And they want to have their own designer supermarket to change the look in the bouquet. But you're right. But we also, I mean, wholesalers are really important to us. And in Colombia, they know the wholesalers, they have better prices.
Yeah.
And they actually they like more than that business. The business with the supermarkets is just about volume. And
yeah, that's the volume.
You are creating the demand here in the States and in other countries. And I'm trying to do the match between the market and the farms.
Yeah,
this is how we work, man.
Yeah, because you guys do a lot with SAF and with Wolfsa. You guys do a lot of different stuff. So yeah,
is that lab in Colombia or in Holland?
We're going to have one in Colombia. Right now it's in Holland, but we're doing it right now.
In Holland. We're testing the varieties in Colombia, but we are going to start breeding. We already start breeding in Colombia.
Awesome.
But for that, you don't need a big lab. You need a greenhouse to keep the codes and the varieties you're going to cross and do the breeding there.
And you guys have a new home.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say, that we got a new farm. Before, we were renting a space and it was beautiful, but now we're in our own place, 8 hectares, and we're very proud because it's, I mean, very innovative. Everything is, I mean...
Congratulations.
Thank you.
It's a beautiful thing.
And we got a lot of milestones last year with the sustainability. And we have all the electricity and all the power goes with solar panels.
The first flower company in the world, carbon neutral.
Yeah. Wow. Congratulations.
I mean, I would expect it. You guys are two young, next-gen, you know, stars. You have to make sure that that's one of the big things that you're working towards.
How long do you guys really know each other?
Yeah.
With David?
Yeah. 10 years? 12?
Probably a little bit more because I started working with your father 14 years ago, and you were...
You're
way
younger,
a pain in the ass, so. So yeah, about 15 years, and we're good friends.
And you guys have
a great dynamic.
A really
Thank
great,
you.
Really, yeah,
we used dynamic. To we used to be neighbors. I mean, like
living together for 8 months.
Yeah, like 100 feet away.
That's
who's
awesome.
The messy one? Who's the clean one?
Well, we weren't that close.
David just pointed at JD.
Real quick, he didn't hesitate.
Well, actually, when we started this podcast, you said 3 words, and I'm going to say that I'm the good. You could be the bad and the ugly.
There you go.
Oh, man.
The scotch is starting to flow now.
I see it. It's a beautiful thing.
Dude, this is the best meeting I've ever
had. I would say you guys are the good and the bad, and then you guys have the beautiful wives, because you guys both have these beautiful wives that were at SAF with Nick by your side, very proud, very nice.
Well, they usually go to one or two trips a year with us, and we're very proud to bring them when we're getting an award or something.
Where are they at?
Yeah. They're shopping.
They should be here. No, they're in Colombia.
Yeah, I know. They're in Colombia.
They're in Colombia with the kids.
We're taking them to SAF this year.
Okay. Cool.
And also the kids, because it's in the JW Marriott
Turnberry. Oh, that's a really fun place for kids.
Yeah.
So. Also has an amazing golf course.
Okay, so she's not coming though.
Amazing golf course.
The wife say we are not working. They say we are always with a. How do you say it?
It's like a.
Paseo de trabajo.
Yeah, it's like a trip, but they say they won't work, but it's not that. It's just that we make our job fun, and you know about this.
You guys love your job.
Oh, yeah.
So it's easily to be confused and say you guys aren't working. You're always working. You're always thinking.
But your friendship is like very evident in just seeing your dynamic together. So I could see where your wives are like, bullshit, you're going to be
You guys are playing, having a good time.
So we're buying some vases for the show that we're doing tomorrow and the next day. And we were getting this big, it's like a martini glass, but it's like a mirror tall. And we're like, this is the only drink that we're going to have today. And they were like, yeah, right, you need that to work, right? And it's just making the
you'll,
job
you'll
fun.
Probably you'll probably sell more.
Oh, yeah.
In good spirits, as they say.
Yes.
Yeah. Spirits as the word drinks. Yeah.
So I also want to congratulate you. I think you are the first in-house guests in our new podcast room.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Mm. Wow, and this is so awesome.
This used to be our preserved rose showroom, but
yeah, now you got your preserved roses.
Ah. That's why we give you guys the alcohol.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, and it's really good. Glenlivet 18. Dude, you're never giving me this
before.
Ooh. Give you Macallan. Yesterday I gave you Macallan.
Yeah, no. This one is better. So what I was telling you when I got here, I mean, half an hour ago, I'm like, this is so beautiful. Once we get in, we were so inspired for all the things and how you treat your employees. So we're getting there, and we put a lot of attention in our
employees. You really enjoy the business also.
Oh, yeah.
Things like a mirror, I think.
So I was talking to Sheila Santiago from SAF, and she was telling us that you guys are like jet fresh. I mean, you're like your spirit is so young. I said your spirit because of you. But we are actually young. Just kidding, Mike. But they say our both companies' spirits are really young, and we're just trying to do something different every time we're doing something. What are these guys are going to do next? I'm referring to you guys. So we kind of have a spy for your social media and stuff. So we can get out of it.
I appreciate the honesty there. I will tell you, but we, even at every show or every time we're together, we gravitate towards each other, right? So it's kind of like minds. People think alike because I look at you guys the same way. I see you guys and what you're putting out and the difference and the changes in the chrysanthemum game. I mean, it's different. We really don't even sell chrysanthemums yet. We hang out every chance we get,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. Yeah.
So, you know, it's one of those wild things.
There is a resurgence of chrysanthemums.
There is. They're coming back.
Do you guys feel responsible for that?
I want to be humble. So, yes, we are. No, just kidding. we think so because, I mean, before the chrysanthemum, it was only like the daisy or the centini just to accompany the bouquet. But because it's so versatile, you can get everything with that. I mean, we work with this supermarket, and we asked them for 70 bouquets that they have, like, year round.
I think we're part responsible to increase the chrysanthemum market.
Yeah,
in America. So I think
I
we're
say
part.
It like that.
That's why I say part.
Yeah, yeah. But what I'm saying is that they gave us 70 bouquets that they have, and we changed all the flowers that weren't chrysanthemums, and we made them, and they saved like 70%. And you can actually see different texture on chrysanthemums because. The other flowers, I know you can change colors and that's it, but Chrysanthemum is so versatile that you can have, like, from a bowl to a cremon to a football mom to a spider.
Well, I mean, now it is. Now, yeah. I mean, there's so many different options. And, like, the ball cremons are my favorite. They, you know, it's an amazing
That's one of our newest categories.
That's not new.
That's what I'm telling you. That's not new flowers. We are selling different. Yeah. Because that's a new. Anemones are not new. Santinis are not new. Dahlias.
Years ago, when you could import from Holland into the U.S. chrysanthemums, we're not allowed to do it anymore. It's some stupid bullshit thing that the USDA agriculture.
No, I know, but also because of rust. But they grow very expensive.
Doesn't matter. If the quality people pay for it. The thing is, years ago, we used to get these ping pong balls round. They used to wrap each flower in its own white paper sleeve. I mean, it was amazing products that, that we used to be able to get. I'm waiting for somebody to get that idea in South America to produce it to the quality that the Dutch do and to package it. Like the Dutch do, because they still produce it and they still distribute it all over the world, except to the United States. So imagine that beautiful ping pong ball in a white wrapper and 10 stems and a big fat bunch.
What would the sales price be difference? Like, what are you talking difference price wise? For
$1 a stem,
yeah,
easily, versus 50 cents, you know?
So I'm all for a better box value every day.
Somebody can, like, get out of the supermarket loop and, like, specialize in the wholesale higher-end chrysanthemum market. Like, I'd be in all in on that.
But there are some growers trying to do that now.
And 20 years ago in Colombia, yep. They also always do that with their football moms. They put in this wrapper. I guess they because this is the same price. I mean, the people that buy flower, that buy chrysanthemums here, they pay the same for their stem, either if it's to open or not open, or is a spray chrysanthemum, or is a disbudded chrysanthemum. So I think they just concentrate on the small guys or the mid farms are concentrating in three colors, white, yellow.
Stop hitting
pink.
The fucking table, man.
That was David, though.
It's a race. It's a race for the price. But Mike, now with the new categories, we are trying to sell the chrysanthemums different. We are trying to.
Yeah.
Probably, I don't know if the word is compete or trying to be similar of Gerbera with the magnums, with the marguerites, trying to be with the hydrangea like with the magnums.
Yeah,
it's not compete. It's just to complement.
So we're trying to compete with different categories, not only competing with the same chrysanthemums.
But to get that Dutch look, you need the giant foliage. It's so crucial to have the big, green, crispy foliage. The flower is one thing, but to give it that oomph, to give it the wow factor, the big, heavy bunch.
No, but that's happening right now. That's happening right now because right now we got like four customers that go directly to Holland and to United Kingdom.
To UK.
And they grow differently. I mean, they said that Europe type.
And, oh, really?
Yeah.
To the U.S.?
Yeah. No,
yeah, not that, to the that, U.S., not to us.
No, but one of the farms that goes there wants to start big in the United States. So it's going to be the same flowers.
Okay, so whoever that guy is,
hook us up.
Please give me the card. Or girl, whoever they are, just growing that different, because that's the shit we want to be in.
As soon as we are off air, I'll tell you
who's that. We want to be in that business. We can't compete as a small middleman. We can't compete selling pom-poms, let's say. I sell pom-poms, but only Esmeralda brand because my customers will pay a little more for that brand. We sell a lot of disbuds, and especially from Ecuador. We're bringing a lot of them from Ecuador. When the price is moderate, we can buy them. When the price is full, we can't because of freight and everything. We're not competitive, but we're selling a lot more.
We are a lot more than we ever have.
Disbuds, but pom-poms, like, unless it's something boutique and unique and different, we can't. It just, the price difference is so big. Plus, we don't bring sea containers.
I'm going to make a box of the stuff that we have at the hotel, And we're going to send you outstanding stuff that you've never seen and you didn't even know.
We're going to come by. We're
well,
come
we're
by.
Definitely okay. going yeah. by to
You're
see.
You're
going to
be there.
Yes. Awesome.
Yeah, we'll be
we're
there.
We're going to support Perfect. You guys, obviously. Yeah.
Perfect. Because you're going to see something that...
Because that's where we can collaborate on yeah. that kind of yeah. stuff.
For the listeners who don't know, what's at the hotel? What's going on?
Yeah.
Every February, like start of February, we like to disrupt the industry and mess with their Valentine's.
As it, I was going to say, as if they're not busy enough.
All the people is complaining, yeah. but all the people is there, sure. always.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, so we're bringing around 100 varieties, 113 actually, and 25 of them are brand new. And we're having the show in the Doral room at the Homewood's Hotel
Hilton.
Airport West. And we're going to be...
How'd you get rid of all the hookers?
They only come out at night.
Who said they did?
They only come exactly. out at night.
Ryan knows
they,
us.
They come out at night, and they end the show at 4 o'clock.
He knows everybody's stressed about They're Valentine's smart. Day. He's trying to solve yeah. two problems.
Exactly. He's worried about people's mental wellness.
Yeah. It's going to be, yeah, after hours, it's going to be a
pink pony. That's great. They know the pink pony.
Is that still in business?
No, it's not.
No, it is.
No, it's not.
Flower yeah, it is. Person, it Wait, absolutely is.
Pink pony's still there, what? For sure.
Yeah.
You guys.
Yeah, you should know.
Man.
We got some names from pink pony to the flowers.
Oh, that's right. But don't tell anybody.
Oh, shit.
No, no, no.
Yeah. Next time you see a variety called Crystal or Ferrari.
Or Diamond. Diamond.
Or Milagros.
Come
on. Oh.
We could bleep
that's,
it, don't worry.
That's actually a
Your
story.
Your wives don't listen to the podcast.
One of our newest varieties called Milagros, and it's named after one of the beautiful dancers that we saw there.
Oh, Lord.
That's amazing. I mean, yeah, why not, right?
I went to the Pink Pony like 20 years ago with Edwin the Doctor, and it was an experience, but it was...
Because you were with Edwin, first of all.
Yeah, he knew everyone. He knew them all, everybody there.
Everyone walked in.
But I didn't think they were still in business. I don't know. That's a long time. That place was old.
I mean,
then.
It might be like a new,
no,
new building.
No, it's changed ownership several times.
Oh, it's been renovated?
Times. Yeah.
Okay.
You're a VIP client?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is our Valentine's season.
Stress relief, okay?
When we need it more than ever.
This is our sponsor for the podcast episode.
And you almost weren't on this episode.
Wow, I know. Chicka, wow, wow.
Can you imagine if I wasn't on this episode, what you guys would talk about?
Yeah. So, where were we? Tootsies.
He's just going to go across That's the amazing. Board and lame them off.
How often are you in Miami?
Yeah, often enough.
Like, yeah, seriously. Like, that's what I want to know.
Like More than enough, I think.
Okay. Wow.
The yeah. holy pinnacle is Scarlett's, by the way.
Okay. Oh,
Scarlett's, okay. If you haven't been to Scarlett's, that's the spot.
We went to Mons Venus in Tampa.
Oh, Tampa. No, Tampa's... I heard Dan Riley
dangerous.
Is our
Do
resident
not go to
strip
Tampa.
Club well, I, advisor, and he says Tampa's got a weak strip club game.
Weak strip club game.
Well, actually, I went to St. Petersburg College... my first 2 years of college in Clearwater, Florida, mm-hmm. and when we went to
where did you graduate from?
UF.
Go Canes.
He was
Go
waiting to
Gators.
Do that.
And but we used to go there in Dale Mabry with all the well those bars, and it wasn't bad. I mean, that was 2002.
College life is amazing
oh, that's
in
right.
Florida.
Yeah.
College, oh, no, the yeah. college yeah. life is way different than everything else.
Yeah.
Especially when you get up, you know, out of Miami, the college life is just
yeah.
I used to go hang out in Gainesville
yeah.
all the time.
Casey, too. He used to go up there, too.
We used to
Gator
leave.
Gator Grawl?
Gator Grawl, but anything. We would leave on a Friday and come back Sunday night nice. And go hang
DCF
out.
DCF was big.
Go
that
hang
too.
Out at the Gators.
I graduated in 2004.
Hit on their
I
girls.
Still go there. I still go there just to see what's going
You're
on.
You're not hitting on the girls still, right?
No, no. Of course not. No.
Well, that depends.
No, no, no.
It depends on if my wife is watching this episode.
Well, there's all kinds of trouble here.
You know, like, talk about Pink Pony.
So, oh.
What else?
Oh. These guys bring their dates to the strip club.
So he's old school strip club.
That's
he doesn't
disgusting.
Know about like how people do it nowadays.
Yeah. He doesn't
it's
know
just go
that
to have a good time. Like you
there's
don't have to...
more. There is more women in a strip club not stripping than men most nights.
No, but I did that 10 years ago with my wife in Colombia. I went to a strip club with her, and it was normal. Like everybody else thought she was one of them, but...
Yeah, but doesn't your wife say, stop looking at her. Stop looking at her.
No.
She don't care?
She's pointing them out.
Nowadays, the girls are checking out the girls more than the guys are checking
you,
them out.
You don't know the perverts you got working here, Mike.
Well, I know some of them. But not all of them, apparently.
You're learning. Yeah. Don't worry. You're learning. It's fun now.
So we were together with all the team in Amsterdam in a strip club.
Oh, yeah, yeah. We took directors to, I mean,
we were five together.
Yeah, we were five. We went to Amsterdam. We got into, it was Casa Rosa or something like that?
No, it was.
Oh, no.
It wasn't a fancy strip club.
Yeah. We went there.
Was it the ping pong show?
No, it wasn't.
Let's get off of that subject.
Yeah, Joelle's ready to apply to Deliflor.
I was going to say, we went from 2 weeks ago with Terrell Neal saying that he would kick anybody out of the program if they went to any of the strip clubs in Holland.
In Amsterdam, yeah.
Well, that's why they were at school.
I've only heard stories.
That's another gator.
Yes, he's another gator, yeah. We have a lot of gators in the industry.
In the industry, yes.
It's a horticulture school, too, yeah.
So let's get back on topic. David, second generation?
Second, yeah.
How did Deliflor start? How did your father start the company? And when did you decide you were going to follow in his
footsteps? We can call him if you want.
What's funny is that...
He forgot English.
If you see David and his dad next to each other, it's just like the same exact person.
I started in the business like 15 years ago. But at that time, I used to work for a cookie company and I used to manage supermarkets at that time. And my father had a very small company with two friends and we used to produce the tint. You use a lot the paint and the flower food also.
You owe me a lot of money.
Or you.
That's how I met you, David.
I think yes.
Yeah.
We were competitors.
Yeah,
remember?
Well, before competitors, I came and I gave you a tour of the wholesale
in the
Miami.
Wholesalers. Yeah. Because we were trying to do something together, a synergy with the spray cans.
Yes.
And at that time, I started in the company called Bioflora, and I developed that company for 12 years. And during that period, I learned a lot about flowers because I was an agent for machinery in the post-harvest. So I have sold a lot of machinery in Colombia, and I developed that business in logistics with the post-harvest and the binders machine. Also, I was an agent for a lily company, everything related with the Dutch people.
Selling bulbs
in Colombia. And also, I used to produce the tints and the paints, and I developed the business in Ecuador and in Colombia. And
so do you know that I was one of the guys that brought the painted business to Colombia?
It's another one
of those things I'll never get anything for. But let me tell you, it was probably in the late 80s, early 90s.
He was born in the 80s.
I was buying flowers from Don Patino from
Oriente.
Flores de Oriente. Oriente. Yeah. From the father.
Yeah.
From Jorge's dad.
And he was one of the best tint companies.
And I sent him tints because I was buying them from Holland. They were so fucking expensive. And I was like, man, what if we can do this in Colombia? And we sent him, we used to get like flower dye. They used to come in glass bottles. And I sent it down to him. And he started the process, and it started to work. And
20 years ago, he was the best tinting flowers. Yeah.
Yeah. And let me tell you, the first bad experience we had, and this is a funny story. I don't know if I ever said it on the podcast before, but he called me half as a joke and half with a big problem because the guys in the post-harvest, they dumped the dye in the drain, and the drain went down to the river.
The
river turned blue.
And the
guy down the river was complaining because his cows were drinking
blue water.
This is true.
And the milk was blue.
Maybe.
Is that where they get the bluebell ice cream from?
No, but I really remember that we had been one of the first to send that tinting process, absorption dye. And then it went to a whole nother level with the airbrushing and the other stuff. But
do you like that?
What, the airbrush?
Yeah. No, not the airbrush. The absorption. I mean, the tinting flowers.
It had its time.
They buy a lot, tinted flowers. A lot.
It had its time.
No, it has to have, yeah.
I think, especially in the mass market, the airbrushing is way better for the consumer.
Yeah.
And it also gives the flower more vase life, and the foliage doesn't die.
Yeah.
Because the foliage is the first to go when you absorption dye chrysanthemums. But the airbrushing, it leaves it all on the flower.
That's even better, yeah.
Yeah, but I'm not sure it's better for the people.
No, and it's more expensive.
Like in our farm, we do airbrushing. Like I'm crazy about the safety equipment. Like I want to wear goggles. I want to wear a gas mask. I want to wear protection.
It's not easy, the process.
The process is not easy.
It's not easy, the process.
And I have been on a lot of farms where the people are not protected.
So I spent 12 years in different business related with the flowers. So in fertilizers, in chemicals, in bulbs, in flower food, in machinery. And at the end, my father has to be retired, and it was like 5 years ago.
If you put David and his dad next to each other, the only difference is the color of the hair. They're like carbon copy.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's really nice.
I know.
No, I don't think so.
Right. I think so, but
You've seen him.
Oh, okay.
So he retired like 5 years ago. And at that time, the Dutch guy offered me the job. And I said, I don't know, because I have my own company. Let me manage. I don't know how to manage these things. And we could sell the company. We could sell the company to the biggest competitor, to Color Química at that time. And that's how I started in Delhi, for more or less a long, short story. But now I've been in Delhi for 4.5 years.
Were you already married at that point, or you met your wife afterwards?
No, I got married 15 years ago.
So it's right before.
A long time ago.
Right before.
I got married, and at the same time, I started in the flower business.
Yeah.
Smart man.
Yeah. And he has two beautiful boys, right? Really? Two boys.
Mm-hmm. How old? Sons, Pedro and Miguel. Mm-hmm. It's 11 and 7.
Okay.
And they enjoy the flowers a lot.
That's third generation right there. Mm-hmm.
There you go. Could be. Getting them ready. What about you, JD? When did you start in the industry, and when did you start at Deliflor?
I started in 2004. I used to own this valet parking company in Tampa. And when I graduated from UF, I went back to Colombia, and I wanted to put this business in Colombia. And but my friend from San Jose, California, he has this restaurant, Havana Cuba. So go there if you're listening to this. And
where is it at?
It's in San Jose, in Race Street. And he told me
that near San Diego?
No, nowhere near.
It's near San Francisco. Like
yeah, it's south of San Francisco. Yeah.
So he needed more. He needed valet parking because he only had 20 spaces and he needed to multiply there for lunchtime and dinner time. So I went there for 2 months to set up everything, and I met a guy in the industry, in the flower industry. And but we were just friends. Then when I got back in Colombia, my mother had sent my resume to this flower company. I went there to the meeting, and it was three people trying to get the job. And they gave us a pool of customers, and they said whoever gets more business gets the job. So I didn't know anything about flowers. I knew how to buy
flowers.
That
is fucking great.
And the other two guys, they used to work for flower companies. I'm like, still. Okay. And I start looking at the list of companies, and one of those companies was the one that of the guy that I used to smoke with.
the valet, when you were in the valet.
I was in the valet. So I call him, and hey, I need to sell you flowers because I'm getting this job. I'm like, okay, put 200 boxes on a pre-book. I didn't know what that was. So I called my manager and I told her, okay, I sold 200 boxes pre-book to this customer. And I'm not going to say the name because I don't. So so let's say the last name of this guy is Jet Fresh, okay? And so my manager was like, there's no way. We've been trying to get this customer here, and there's no way that you, on your first call, you're getting 200 half boxes in on a pre-book. It wasn't a pre-book. It wasn't standing order.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. He almost got hired as sales manager.
Exactly. So let's say his last name was Jeff Fresh, and then we met with the owner of the company, my manager and me, and we call him, hey, Jerry, they don't believe me. I sold this to you. He's like, no, yeah, it's for real. Okay. And so the owner of the company asked him, so Jerry, what's your last name? I'm Jerry Jetfresh. So he was the owner of the company. So we got that. So that's how I started the business. That was Miramonte.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Wow, before they went elite. And
so who was your boss there? Laura?
Laura was my boss
Laura
there.
Laura G?
Yeah, Laura. And then
Gonzalo.
But actually, because I was the first executive sales executive from here, but working for the United States. So actually, my boss was Laura Gerhol and Barbara
Montes.
Yeah,
Montes,
Barbara,
yeah.
Barbara Montes. Mm-hmm. And
those ladies are the OG pom pom ladies of Miami.
Yeah. Barbara Montes was nonstop. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
She's still going. Yeah. I spoke to her recently.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
she's still working. Multiflora.
Yeah. Multiflora, yeah.
No, Barbara Montes.
She was managing a Mayesh, I think, in the Carolinas for a while. She was very good to me. Both of them were very good to me.
Yeah, to me too. And everything, I see them around, and it's like. Aunt.
And the sale was a Barbie, the sales lady?
Yeah. Barbie Cooley.
She was so Cooley.
Was that?
Does she still work there?
Yeah. Miraflor.
Mimi loves the dad jokes.
I love the jokes.
So Miraflor is owned by Elite?
No, I think that Miraflor got for the Guardians de los Andes and that stuff. Gardens America.
Gardens America.
Yeah.
They got nice flowers.
Yeah.
Yes, I love Gardens of America.
Gardens of America, that's nice where Gems gets their flowers.
Yes.
Christine,
So, Carlos Aramis.
Yeah, good guy. Go Carlos. Yeah. So
he's a brilliant guy.
Yeah.
Brilliant guy.
Yeah, he talks too fast.
Well, that's you gotta slow it down, Carlos. Yeah.
That's because the thoughts are going faster.
I know, exactly.
Let's try to keep up.
Yeah.
Brain don't stop there.
Yeah, brain just keeps going. The guys are loaded with ideas.
Yeah. So I worked for like 3 years at Miramonte, and then I decided that I knew everything about flowers. So I bought this piece of land, built a greenhouse, and start growing flowers, but the only thing I knew about flowers was to sell them. So I struggled for like 5 years with that farm.
My father rented.
No, not that one. It's next door to your father.
All right.
Yeah, but we also used your father farm for that endeavor, but I didn't do good, but I still have the farm. And
the growing world is a different world,
exactly,
isn't it?
Exactly, yeah. And I wanted good varieties, so I went to Manuel to ask him for good varieties of chrysanthemum to start selling, and he's like, no, you need to work here. Just leave your farm. That's what I did. And that was me 14 years ago when I started in Deliflor. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
And the first time I saw you was at an SAF convention during a poker. You guys used to do the poker matches, and then you were.
Oh, you guys play poker?
Poker. Yeah. I just met.
He plays everything.
Are you going to be here Friday?
This is a poker table.
Is a professional poker table.
Yeah, we're going to play poker on Friday.
We're leaving Friday.
Playing everything.
I love to play.
And it was my first SAF convention, and I see these guys, and everybody's leaving early, and I'm like, where are they going? They're like, and it was like an all guys group, and then they saw a couple
room,
girls
right?
at the bar. They're like, you guys can come too if you want to lose some money. And the girl I was with at that time, she was like, let's go because I know how to play poker. I'm like,
who
I am
that?
Not going. She used to work for John Henry.
John yeah. Henry, the one with the little cards.
Yes.
Okay.
So, and then I remember, and I
know who she is.
The only reason I remember was because it was all like, you know, Dutch guys, and then you.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly.
Now, I was like their pet.
Yeah.
Their mascot. Let's say mascot. Yeah.
But you've been very involved in SAF.
Oh yeah. Well, not only SAF, every association. I mean, you see me more in SAF because they do more outside, but every like association in the flowers, I'm doing something there.
You're speaking.
I am speaking.
Time, right? Next gen?
Next gen, yeah.
Oh, Ryan's speaking
nice.
Too.
Really?
Oh, and Casey. Okay.
Oh, yeah, but not on Sunday. I'm doing that on Sunday 25th, and then I have to go to Anaheim for the rear showcase for IFPA.
Okay. You're also in charge for SAFPAC, the golf tournament?
Not anymore, because we don't have a golf tournament anymore.
Well, that's why we invited you here today. No, I'm just kidding.
No, I finished my three-year commitment with the Growers Council last year, and in my last the last thing that I said there was that please bring back the golf tournament, not because I want to co-chair it, no, it's just because I want to play it, and every time it's a nice venue.
I sat in on that a couple times, the Growers Council, yeah. the Wholesale Council, yeah. And the Retail Council. I sat in on all of them.
I saw you in the yeah. Growers Council.
That's pretty cool stuff.
Yeah.
You're in there with some, like, big names.
Yeah.
So that's pretty cool.
Yeah. JD is one of their names.
There should be. I mean,
we're doing the Blooms and Birdies again this year.
We are doing Blooms and Birdies.
I think
Casey, we want to do that annually.
Yeah.
We want to do that. We'll have a golf tournament here, Blooms and Birdies.
During our Fresh Fest, we had a golf tournament as well. But the golf tournament was really hard to get everybody to come because we had it on Thursday because our big event was Friday. So although it was hard to manage to have so many events in that week, we had a very successful golf tournament, so everybody's been asking. And Casey and Fern can't get off the greens.
No, we're doing it. We're doing it again this year.
I'll make sure you get an invite.
Don't worry, you will definitely get an invite.
Are you a good golf player?
No, I suck, but I have a great time.
Because
Casey's really good.
Oh, yeah, I have played
I
with
like
him.
To play with Casey.
I play with him at the
exactly the same
Keys Kane.
They Kane. Drink I'm and the, smoke at every hole.
Yeah. I'm the worst. Yeah.
It's all about just
I'm a good
but I can drive.
I'm a good
drink.
I can drive, drink, and smoke. Right. And then Casey gets us on the green, and I'm a good putter, so I can putt.
Okay.
So me, I'm like, all right, Casey, get us on the green, and I'll putt it in, and we're good to go. Let's keep going.
So when I was co-chairing the show, Debbie was just starting in the business. I'm like, dude, you have to play golf. I mean, you get 5 hours to talk to whoever is in your car, and then when you're teeing up, you're talking to the other guys. So I'm going to put you in a great group. And he's like, no, if I'm going to play, I'm playing with you in the same car, and we're going to get drunk. I'm like, okay, let's do it. And then
what a tough decision.
Yeah. So it was Karen Oy from Smear Oasis.
She's good, right?
Oh, she's really
very
good.
Yeah,
she's really good.
Who's that?
Karen from Smithers Oasis.
We go to Fibs every year in Michigan to play 24 people. We play the Cramps. They have this tournament. It's awesome. This year, I don't think I'm going to be able to go because SAF is first week of August this year. So, and the last
you
day
took me out to your group.
So but don't spoil
serious
my story.
Golfers take it serious, man. Casey won't put he won't put me in his group for that reason.
No, but
he's trying to win.
So the thing is, I mean, it was Ken Tagawa was walking around. He didn't have a group. I'm like, this guy I don't know, 90 years old. He's looking for a group. He's big name in the industry. Like, okay, Davey, I'm going to put you over here in this group. And I got Ken Tagawa play with us.
You kicked him out. That's messed up. Yeah.
And then I put in this awesome group because I wanted him to be friends with the Whoops of Pressing. That was Ben Powell at the time. And I put in the same car with him. And first time it was his first time swinging, driving a ball. And when Ben saw him doing his swing, Ben is like, what the hell is going on here? Oh, my
JD,
God.
JD, what did you do to me, JD?
Exactly. He didn't know it was me. He knew it was me. I mean, David knew it was me. So I put it there. And so I play with Karen, with Mike, and with Ken.
and we got the tournament. We won.
Wow.
Are you guys coming down for WFSA?
Oh, yeah. Yep.
All right. So WFSA has a golf tournament this year.
Of course. At the Golden.
I'll see you there.
Yeah, I'll see you there.
He's ready. You guys got to make a wager.
Yeah. Let's do it. Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah. And there's a game playing golf that is called putting poker.
What is that?
Every time, I mean, if you get into the, once you get into the green, mm-hmm. you if you put one, you get a card. If you make your putt, you get a card. If you make it in two, you have to pay $5. And if you make it in three, you get a coin and also pay $5. At the end, you play poker with whatever amount of cards you have. You choose your five bets.
So you got no cards? You got no cards.
And after that, you can go to the ping pong.
And whoever wins that hand gets the whole purse.
Wait, Mike, didn't you go the other day to play with Casey? How'd you do?
I think my pink pony.
No, not a pink pony. Mike wouldn't go there.
My son's bought me a golf lesson.
And how did it go? I never heard anything else after. I saw you with your gear.
I enjoyed it.
Yeah?
Yeah. I learned how to, the right way to stand and the right way to shoot and hold the club.
So for our golf tournament, you'll be playing.
But I need a few more lessons. Okay. That was not enough.
Yeah.
So you're going to play in the golf tournament this year is what you're saying. Mm. You're going to be ready.
I'll be your caddy.
I kind of suck.
So what course do you guys play?
We played Crandon Park last year. And it doesn't mean that it won't be Crandon Park this year, but it could be Miami Beach. Miami Beach is nice. Or Normandy Shores.
Miami Beach is the one like a really good one. With Casey.
Just make it like a good one.
Let's do Trump.
Mm. Sure.
Let's do Trump. Okay. I'm a fan of Trump.
Trump course.
Blue Monster.
So what do you play, David? Tennis?
Tennis.
I knew it. You look like a tennis player.
Tennis.
Because of the...
And I used to play soccer.
What about pickleball?
What do you think? What do you think about pickleball?
No, I've never played pickleball.
Pickleball is bigger than
SAF. Better for me.
Paddle, right? Paddle,
okay. Yeah. I mean,
paddleball.
We went in Santa Monica a couple months ago, and people were playing.
You guys are athletes. You're not messing around.
Yeah. and we saw people playing pickleball. Dude, that looks hard
and really fast. It's really hard.
A lot of the SAF people are into pickleball.
Yeah?
Yeah, like Oscar and Fernandez, Renato. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's because we're all talking about it.
They're trying to get like a...
They want to do a tournament.
Yeah, a tournament.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll stick to golf.
Yeah, me too.
Now's your time to shine, Dave.
Yeah.
I can't drive. I stay with you in the golf.
There we go. Yeah, if you're playing pickleball, I mean, I would spill my drink.
Let's talk about all the awards and accolades that you've gotten in the past couple years.
Yeah. Can we list them?
From SAF, we got 196 ribbons.
Shit.
What? Yeah.
Damn.
196.
Holy fuck.
Yeah, it's
part of my language. Fuck.
Oh, but who helps you with that?
Mimi is always.
You can't be saying that shit.
Mimi is always there.
Well, I don't help them. I don't do anything. I'm never on the to pick the awards, but I'd like to prepare the. I love.
How much money do they pay you?
Nothing. Yeah, are you preparing theirs better than ours?
I have tried.
I receive no money. Right, but it's very important that we know that moving forward, if you do not book it, they cannot handle it. So I can't touch anything unless you do pay.
So she should be really proud because, I mean, the Outstanding Varieties competition is. I mean, every flower can compete there, so they bring this. Amazing roses, the big hydrangeas, the David Austin, the proteas, everything. So it's impossible that a chrysanthemum can win best in show. But then she arranged so beautiful one of our varieties. It's called Alma. Kaching.
Kaching.
You won a gold medal for Alma.
We got gold medal, but before we got best in show in Palm Springs in California, we got best in show with that variety, first chrysanthemum that
week. And it was what variety was that?
Alma. And it was a white daisy won best in show among another 265 varieties. Different varieties. So,
wait,
we were very
how many did Alma did you sell? I remember that from the SAF award.
We
it's our number one variety.
5 years ago, we sold 24,000, this year we sold 90 million.
Damn!
90 million.
90 million.
From 84,000.
For those of you who can jump over to the Deliflor Americas Instagram and check out Alma, it's gorgeous. It is a beautiful white chrysanthemum. It's perfectly, like, it's pure white. Like, it's not even, you don't see a single petal that's translucent.
And the green center is so beautiful. The variety is symmetric, very, 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 very beautiful. I mean,
it's the contrast between that green and that, look at how beautiful it is.
Yeah. So my name is JD, is Juan David. It's short for Juan David, and some people call me Juan Dalma.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that was a big award that you got at SAF.
Yeah, so the prize, they have been giving that prize for 20 years now, and so it's supposed to be 20 awards. But because it's so difficult to get, I think 4 or 5 of those years it's been deserved. So nobody got the prize.
Nobody was worthy enough.
Yeah, exactly.
And with a white daisy.
I didn't want to say it like that. But,
and you put
it
out.
It sounded better when you said it like that.
The best white daisy around.
And daisy.
But it was because it was a success and commercially.
So is it like the marketer of the year award? You need to like show numbers.
Absolutely.
And prove the success.
Yeah, but
of
the
it.
Difference like, with yeah. the marketer of the year is that I want to do marketer of the year this year.
We're working very hard for that.
Yeah.
And, 90 million plants.
And we're based on you because of your prize 2 years ago.
Ryan's a judge now.
Really?
I was a judge last year. I don't know if I'll be again this year. They haven't let me know.
That's now really cool. We're thinking how to build a nice story of all the things.
Oh, he's going to spoil it. Just cut it.
One of the, one of the most...
You've got to be the marketeer of the year.
One of the most impressive images of Alma was when the Botero funeral, the famous artist Botero, and guys, I'm going to show you guys this picture, is with all these Almas. Like, I mean, this is a huge representation. Like, Botero represents part of Colombian culture, and to have that Alma,
I mean,
there,
that is an
it really moved me.
That's an executive looking funeral there.
And you know
let
what?
Tell you.
One of our best clients shipped all those flowers to the funeral. We didn't know that.
You didn't know?
No. They asked for white flowers, for the most beautiful white flower, and they shipped.
But then
only
the,
Alma.
But then the newspaper, they said the variety Alma. So
after you won that award, I called Esmeralda and changed all my white daisies to Alma.
Awesome.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, thank
Rodrigo
you.
Rodrigo loved it.
Yes, he did.
Rodrigo loved it.
Look at how, it's just impressive. Like, they used, how many stems are there?
What's great about that is it looks like the anemone, which gives it that really high-end look.
Yes, it does get a good high-end look.
It's pure white.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Also, when that plane with the soccer team went down in Colombia, we gave away to Alma for the funeral. And so, I mean, we fill a stadium with 70,000 people, and everybody have a stem.
And
in
it's
their
beautiful
hand.
Because of the name. The name Alma means, like, you know,
soul.
So it's beautiful.
Yeah, just like my soul is white, pure white.
Pure white. With a black center.
The black center is called the pink pony.
A moldy stem.
And you also got like the best stand in Pro Flora, right?
No, we didn't.
Sustainability.
Sustainability.
But I thought you had the best stand with those lights and all that.
Me
the
too.
LED lights.
Oh, yeah,
me
sure.
too. That was really good.
What'd
you do? Is that something you rented or you own that?
No, we rented. We rented.
You rented it. Yeah. I really like that.
It was made out of 45 screens.
Yeah, it was
really, really, really. It was like
really
a
nice. Really
will you be at the Ecuador show this year?
Well, actually, Ecuador for us is really important, but it's not as big as Colombia. And we have another show in Colombia at that time, which is the Symposium of Agriculture in Medellin.
Yeah, normally we don't visit that show. We visit the clients before.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah. But you're going like in,
I'm going.
In
I'm
a
going
month.
In 2 weeks.
In 2 weeks. So make sure you go visit them.
Sure.
There's no chrysanthemum grower anywhere near
us. It doesn't matter. He has a lot of free time.
Yeah.
Well, look how cool Joel looks.
He's not traveling for work. He's just having fun, guys.
No. Actually, when he goes to Ecuador, he goes to like 29 farms in one day.
That's like,
is him. There 29 farms growing chrysanthemum?
No,
it's called
the farm.
No.
That's not like four. Only four farms.
Yeah.
Four or five farms. Yeah. That's it. Small farms.
Yeah. But increased
not
a lot.
So small.
Yeah, they're not so
there's
small.
There's some big availabilities now on this buds.
It's like 40 hectares total in chrysanthemums.
A bit less.
Not even, yeah. Mm.
Compared to how many hectares being grown in Colombia of chrysanthemums?
Like
1,100.
Yeah. Wow. It's a big difference.
I know.
That's huge.
Huge.
But that's where most of the bouquet making goes on in Colombia. It doesn't go on like that in Ecuador.
Yeah, but in Colombia, they only have chrysanthemums and roses and hydrangeas. So they have to bring some other flowers to...
So with the new categories and new varieties, we're trying to increase the share of chrysanthemums in the bouquets.
Mm-hmm. Do you guys also do these like exclusivities like the rose breeders are doing?
Not really.
No.
Not really. Not,
no?
Not really.
We're
not
looking into.
Not yet.
We're going to see what's
don't do it. Exclusivities are bad. They're bad for the small growers.
I know, exactly.
Are you growing anything weird and crazy like the veggie and that kind of stuff?
Oh, you're going to see that when you go to
our show. That's what's at the show.
It's these varieties that are called the Etruscos. That's like the Smurf house.
Yeah.
It looks like it, and
it's a freak.
It's a freak. Exactly.
I love freaks.
People are into that now. Yeah.
The more freaks, the better.
And you're gonna love them, but you're gonna help me how to
pack it
because it's weird.
I can help you.
Yeah, very cool.
I can help you. I like freaks.
Okay.
My dog's a freak.
No, I've seen your office.
He's got an office full of freaks. They
gave a real great analogy. They call their office like Spencer's Gifts.
Yes.
I think that's a perfect analogy.
What is Spencer's Gifts?
That's the store in the mall that sells like everything from like toys and t-shirts to like sex
stuff. Oh, I know the place. I used to have to take Connor there.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I know.
Yeah.
You get everything
they
there.
They sell t-shirts and then...
The weirder the better.
T-shirts and anime.
I bought an inflatable Hillary Clinton.
There you go.
Am I going to get arrested?
Say that again.
You know that store, Mike, it has like tchotchkes, but at the same time, if you go to the back of the store, it's not tchotchkes.
This is still toys.
It's still toys.
Exactly.
It's adult toys.
Sex
toys.
It's kind of weird because the beginning of the store.
But why the hell would anyone want
an
inflatable Hillary Clinton?
Everybody
that's what
has
you give
a.
To the guy who
everybody has.
I just wanted to feel like Bill.
You felt presidential.
Then you should have bought a Monica.
I was going to say, if he wanted that, nah, he should have bought a little kid.
Exactly.
Oh, Ryan.
I did after.
You should have got
you guys are bringing the
a Jeffrey Epstein.
I was going to say, yeah, exactly.
Jeffrey
Epstein or a...
I feel like this is definitely the most
what was the name of the lady? Guillain Maxwell.
Yeah.
Jocelyne, right? Jocelyne?
Yeah, it's a weird way to pronounce it, yeah.
We're going to take it as a compliment.
Yeah, definitely.
When I told Mommy we're going to the Bahamas for Valentine's. I told her we're going to stay at the Epstein Island.
Oh, Lord.
I could see her not even knowing what that means.
She's like,
just being like, oh, great,
nice.
Let's do it.
I can't wait to get there.
So this episode airs after Valentine's Day.
Correct.
So, yeah.
This is 102.
So we do have to give a quick, tell us where you're going for Valentine's Day so we know, because this is very sweet and romantic of you.
Listen to this,
listen
man.
To this,
is man.
Listen to this man. Listen to this man.
He's a teddy bear.
Hey.
I'm taking my wife to the Bahamas for the weekend.
Where are you staying?
We're leaving on Valentine's Day.
Are you going to Atlantis?
No, I don't like Atlantis.
You know what happened last week?
Yeah, dude. Yeah.
No, what happened?
And this seems like
did a shark
like
eat
TMZ?
Somebody?
A shark? It's a shark. A shark took off. Like, did the boy die?
No.
No, he did. No. But they were doing those shark experiences. Guys, we shouldn't do those kind of experiences with animals.
Yeah, that's just
why is that news? If you jumped in with sharks swimming,
you got bit
by a shark. Why is that news?
I don't know.
I want to swim with the sharks, but I want to be like in a cage.
In a cage.
Like,
yeah.
Me not seen the videos where the shark goes in the cage?
Yeah. I'll punch a shark.
Okay. When we first moved to Florida, My wife's always had this thing where she always had wanted to swim with the dolphins. And when we first moved to Florida, I found out that the Seaquarium...
Miami Seaquarium.
The Seaquarium would let you swim with dolphins, like a private thing. So this is before it was a bad
thing to do.
No, cool. I'm saying no because dolphins are known to be very sexual animals when they swim with females.
No, we didn't have that problem.
Yeah. Oh, okay, good, good, good.
So
it was just a nice family outing with dolphins.
Oh,
it wasn't
You guys got me on the X-rated podcast episode now. I've been very quiet this episode, yeah. Okay?
Can't take Mimi nowhere.
God. Right here, you need to hear moaning.
Oh, yeah?
Right here. We took her, we blindfolded her, and we drove... We had a full size van. I have five sons. We have a full size van. We all loaded up in the van, and we drove down to Miami Seaquarium. And man, she had a good time. Everybody swam with the dolphins. The boys swam
that's
with the
nice.
Dolphins. They were pretty cool.
Yeah. Why didn't you go in the water?
Because they fucking smell.
I was just thinking about it now. Everyone went in but you.
I didn't pay for myself. I paid for all you guys.
Oh, thank you.
I was broke as fuck at that time.
It was cool though. Like you would sit there and you'd put your feet back and they would put his nose on your feet and like push you through the water. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Well, just to defend the sharks in the Bahamas, on average there's only 16 shark attacks per year and there's only one fatality every 2 years. I mean, and it only happens when you're going to the shark. The shark's not really looking for you. You're not interesting to the shark.
Also, the sharks are confused about the water temperatures and a lot of other things.
And you can see in the video of the little kid, he bits the kid and then he just...
Yeah, it's right not...
The sharks have survived...
The kid was taunting him.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, more than humans.
I also saw in Atlantis that their little shark tunnel that you walked through had a crack and was leaking on people.
Hell no.
I don't like Atlantis because they try to milk you everywhere you go.
Atlantis.
And they rip you off. Everything is...
I took the family there. I took the family there a couple years ago. That place is expensive.
Yeah.
I got raped on the poker table. Okay, I got raped everywhere I went there.
We're going to delete those.
Yeah, but
words.
Don't blame Atlantis for your lack of poker skills.
It was a rough go there.
That's right.
No, I just don't like Atlantis. It's too big. It's too commercial. Yeah. I like those little more private hotels.
Well, I like their water park.
Yeah. Well, your kids are really going to like the Turnberry here in Miami, Fort Lauderdale.
The water park there is
my one key.
I know. But your son's too little for that. How old is he?
It's he turned 2 in November.
You could still do the lazy river.
No,
lazy
but river. He can do the little park.
There's
park
a little one. There's two
around.
Little parks. Yeah.
I'm gonna be at all the meetings. I'm just gonna throw in a pool on that.
There's a lifeguard somewhere.
Here's some floaties. Figure it out.
Give David's kids. They have to watch him.
they love him.
I'm the good father.
He's the godfather.
Oh really? Oh my goodness.
That's great.
You guys are cute.
You really are besties.
Yeah,
that is great.
How does that work for working dynamics? You guys have to leave the friendship outside, or when there's your
we do and we get mad and we don't talk in a week, and when we fight, one of us
husband
leaves the
wife?
Company. So go, fuck you. I'm so sorry.
You're allowed to curse.
You're allowed
we're
to
only
curse.
No. We can talk about porn.
We're rated R.
No one
talked about
no.
Porn,
and now I remember when Mike says stop knocking on my fucking table. Yeah. So.
But normally we
I told you
we
this is like a
buy.
Bunch of industry people sitting at the bar talking shop.
Yeah, I never curse on the bar table. Well, maybe.
Yes, you do.
So I mean, we have our differences, of course, and but we only once have a fight, and then I left.
But like, both of you
don't cry.
Both of you have worked in different companies without each other, and it is way better to have friends at work, right?
Oh yeah, oh yeah. But everybody says the
and David's like maybe.
No. That's why things work very well.
Yeah, because you guys see the same.
I'm sure. Because we trust a lot each other.
Yeah.
We enjoy many things. We're always working and talking shit in the plane, in the bar, in the house, in the barbecue. in a weekend.
So that's what I was going to say, that if we have a fire on a Thursday, I'm not going on Friday to the office, and then we have a barbecue at his house on Saturday.
They don't last too long.
Yeah, no, but we're in a group with like eight friends, and my wife is there, and his wife is there, and they start talking like in code, like, are they back together again? Are they still mad at each other?
We have a group, and we are the four of us.
Oh, yeah. That's
awesome. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Are the wives besties also?
It's called neighborhood.
Neighborhood.
Because we used to live next to each other. So yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, no, it's good. It's good. Well, sometimes it's too much. But it's awesome, yeah.
Well, you spend more time at work than you do at home, you know? Mm-hmm. It's
Yeah, but and we lived next to each other for 8 months, and once we got to the from the office to the house, he's like, "Are you here? Would you like some scotch? Come." So it was after work too.
And then my wife called me, "Hey, where are you? Your car is here, but you're not here."
I'm at JD's. I'll be right there. 8 p.m. He's still in my house, and I did that too. Yeah, so. Awesome. Yeah, they like each other, but they hate us together.
I can imagine.
Not really. You guys get away with a lot.
Not hate, you know. Yeah. It takes a lot for a wife to understand, you know, those kind of relationships. Exactly. Yeah. But I'm sure you guys are fine.
Yeah. So, yeah, sometimes they think that we're doing something wrong, and then we're just throwing boxes just to fit it in the garbage can. That's it. 1 hour playing that.
Where are you?
I got more stories if you need.
Okay, but we're going to go with G-rated stories, right?
I kind of like the dirty stories.
Oh, yeah.
Today's been a great day of dirty stories.
We have some.
Yeah.
It's not the bad of the flower industry. It's just the stuff we don't talk about.
Yeah.
Until we have a few scotches.
I know. Oh, yeah. That's smart.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's loosen you up. It's get you a...
Yeah. We're trying to get all the secrets out.
That's right.
You know?
Yeah.
Do you want to drop another secret right now? Well, we got you on the spot.
Is there something we're going to see tomorrow that's unheard of, new, different?
Well, we got our... Well, we brought 25 bolias, one of the new categories. So we got all the colors there.
What are the, I'm sorry to interrupt. What are the new categories you guys created, just for people who don't know?
So it's... we call them... Bolias is one that is a chrysanthemum.
Looks like a dahlia.
It looks like a dahlia, but it has a round shape.
Okay.
Because we also have some other dahlias. Yeah.
Yeah, bull dahlias. The mom balls.
Yeah.
That's going to be a big deal.
Yeah.
It is.
To be
deal.
Able to have something that looks like a dahlia perform like a chrysanthemum.
Yeah. So we got a new one that is it's a green one. It started 3 years ago and from. 1,500 3 years ago to 18 million this year.
20 million this year.
20 million.
Did Rodrigo already order some of those?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they grow
Alemani. They have it in Esmeralda, and it's named after this flower designer, Pablo Alemani. And he's going to be at the show.
But that's
tomorrow.
The green one.
Yeah.
Its name is Alemani.
Okay. We get that one. We get the green.
So that's one of the bolias.
But
so
that one doesn't look like a dahlia.
It's because the round shape is a ball, but it's because there is no green dahlia, so that's why it doesn't look... You're going to be there tomorrow.
We just started getting this new green, natural green ranunculus.
Okay.
The chartreuse?
Is it green, green?
Green, green.
Oh, okay.
Green like puke.
You know what? green is one of the most difficult color for us.
For chrysanthemum.
For chrysanthemum, green is very difficult.
Yeah, we feel like we're
it's not easy.
They're changing color stage.
It's not easy because it's a bit yellow. It's not dark enough.
If you use
the original, I think it was like a Yoko Ono, right? The green button.
Yeah.
And Atos was green. One that was really...
But Atos came later.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Yoko Ono was first, but it has a little bit chatting, and then we start working on it. But
that was really popular when it first came out.
It was. Oh, yeah. It was popular for a long time.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, he was a pom-pom guy. He worked at Galleria Farms over there.
Yeah.
Slinging pom-poms.
When?
For 8 years.
And when?
7 years and 364 days. Too long. But
was Gary there?
Gary Schwartzbaum.
I just love my Gators.
I love Gary. I don't love the Gators. I don't love the Gators, but I love Gary. Gary's good peoples.
So, so and the other one is the Magritte. Magritte is a Dutch word.
You sparked his interest. He said the right word.
No, Marguerite is the owner of the company.
And the owner of the company.
So there used to be a product, Marguerite Daisy.
Yeah.
It's the same?
It's the same.
You're bringing it back?
It's the same.
No, no, but we're not bringing it back. I'm
looking for someone to bring it back.
Yeah, we're calling it that, but it's not.
Stop hitting my fucking table.
JB, he's not going to tell you again.
I'm not.
So it's but it's not a daisy. It's an anemone. This anemone that looks like a gerbera. Uh-huh. And we're testing 60 right now.
Wow.
And we got 10 that are
commercial
right now.
Is that one in the hotel tomorrow?
Sure. Yeah. One of them is Mooney, Intuition, Enamorada. I mean, we got 10 varieties now.
So I have a guy in Guatemala, Flortech, who's been growing for me for maybe almost 15 years now.
Yeah.
Chrysanthemums?
And he grows snapdragons and he grows some other stuff for us as a contract. But I asked him if he would find some seeds of Marguerite daisies because I want to resurrect it. It used to be a big deal.
I think we can do it. I mean, not the same one, but because the cycle is too long.
That's why we created that category.
Yeah.
So really?
Yeah.
So yeah.
But Marguerite daisies, they were kind of short, maybe 50 centimeter, and their foliage was kind of weak.
Yeah, not ours.
But it was a nice
bunch.
But
the flower looked
like a classic flower.
Yeah.
It was a cheap flower. Marguerite daisies, but in white. You used to get the box. It used to come like 15 white and 5 yellow in an upright box. And the way
we used
to sell
them. Looks like a chamomile, a bigger chamomile.
Oh, yeah, like
exactly.
It.
Exactly bigger. Like a bigger chamomile.
Show me, Mimi.
And it was.
Yeah, that's it.
Like a bigger chamomile.
I recently spoke to Steve Dion about, like, does anyone still grow this out in California? And like, no, nobody has it. But years ago, there was a.
Did you mind about the yellow center?
No, it was a big production. And they used to send them in upright hampers made out of wax-coated boxes. And wholesalers never had to put them in water. The wholesalers just took the whole box and put it in like a pool of shallow water.
Yeah.
And it would drink. We would never have to unpack them and hydrate them.
We had that variety.
That's a cool box.
I wish they would bring all that stuff back.
But the concept...
Do you think the customers want it back or do you want it back?
Customers want... new stuff. They want nostalgic stuff.
Yes,
because that's like classic. What you would see like kind of growing outside.
Like the breeders. The breeders are bringing. They're repurposing patented names from years ago.
And your father is right because it's cyclical.
The trends come back.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm waiting for a breeder to resurrect the Oceana.
Oh my God!
They're resurrecting already other roses. Other Jacaranda is back, but it's a hot pink now.
Yeah, I know,
but it was already hot pink before.
So you breeders, you spend all this money to get these worldwide patents, you know, and then the variety fizzles away. But
we're not
going to
bring Deliflor back, Mike.
Well,
maybe 10 years, 20 years, you might.
No, because it's out of royalties.
The Deliflor was my. I used to have a guy grow Deliflors in Bogota. And this is when I had my bouquet company in New York. And I visited them like twice. They were a nice family, nice people. And one day I was in my warehouse and we were very busy with production. And I was kind of late on my payroll taxes. And these federal agents came in. And they said, you know why we're here, right? I'm like, yeah, I know. And they sat me down and they said, well, why don't you tell us how you do it? I'm like, well... I kind of like needed to pay the rent, so I didn't pay the payroll tax, but I plan on paying the No, the drugs. I'm like, what do you mean the drugs? So this guy who was selling me Deliflor somehow was hollowing out the inside of the flowers in the stems, and they followed the truck to my place from Miami.
Shit.
So they followed it the whole way. Like, I don't even know nothing about it. And they had it all wrong. It was a really scary experience. Meanwhile, that guy disappeared. I don't know what happened to him. But that was my Deliflor. So after that, I never bought another Deli Star again.
You know what? That's
and after that, we changed the Deli Star for Anastasia. Deli Star was Tubo Tridity.
That is season two of Griselda on Netflix.
I'm watching Griselda. I just started.
Your season two. Your season two, Mike.
I watched 2 years, two days ago.
Yeah. What's her name? Sofia
Vergara.
She's a good actress.
No, wait. Mike said Sofia Vergara.
That's more accurate.
That's how he feels.
That's only the way you heard it. But she's a good actress.
She's a really good actress.
She's the best.
Hot.
The most paid. Yeah.
Bad Bunny said she's not pretty in person.
Well, Bad Bunny doesn't know then.
Bad Bunny knows how to sing like a seal.
Yeah, exactly. Like.
So Fridays, you know, you walked in, there was music playing every day. We have a different genre of music playing. Fridays is Latin Friday, and you know, Bad Bunny is like Michael Jackson right now, right? There's a lot of Bad Bunny songs.
I know,
but
Michael gets crazy.
But Michael, tell them which is your favorite. What's your favorite Latin artist that you told me that they're going to be performing at the casino?
El Gran Combo.
Oh, Juanes.
El Gran Combo.
He does like Juanes. Yeah,
Gran Combo is nice.
He was playing Latin rock.
He likes salsa.
I don't like the reggaeton.
Is that a kind of pasta? Maluma?
I love Maluma.
Who said something about pasta?
Reggaeton.
I like the more...
Salsa
music.
So Nietzsche.
Yeah. Or even I was playing the other day, I was playing Latin rock.
Yes.
Yeah, he was playing
Which
Juanes
is pretty good.
All that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But I don't know.
Who was the other?
He doesn't like Shakira either.
No. He doesn't like Sean Paul. Sean Paul's a big no one.
Sean Paul.
What about Carol G?
I hate this song, Gasolina.
Oh, yeah.
Daddy Yankee.
That's not allowed
to be played here. It's not allowed.
I used to hate it, but now when I hear it, I'm like, oh, yeah, well, I remember like...
That time you were drunk in the club? That's exactly where I go.
When we worked at Olimar Flowers, I had a bouquet line going there. There were about 20
people.
We
used to listen 94.9 in Miami.
Yes, all that's the Zeta. Zeta, that's the rock station. Yeah.
Oh, I don't even know.
It's like three songs and an hour and a half of commercial.
Yeah.
I mean,
half Nirvana, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But it's good.
But yeah, he doesn't like Shakira's songs either.
And her hips lie.
He doesn't complain if she's on the screen, though.
And what about Carlos Vives, Mike? Carlos Vives?
Yeah.
Who?
Carlos Vives.
I don't know who that is.
Sing him a song.
Como
la luna que alumbra por la noche dos caminos. Como las hojas al viento. Como el sol escampa frío.
I didn't know Mimi speaks Spanish. Just
kidding. Don't know that one.
Are you guys musicians? Do you guys play instrument or sing?
My brother is a musician.
Okay.
He plays guitar. And he's a recording.
He has a record deal. Wow.
I have a signed record from Fonseca.
Oh, have you heard the new...
His father used to own Discovery Farms.
Yeah, not anymore.
Is that elite now?
Fernando Fonseca.
Fernando, we know him.
Yeah.
Is that an elite place now?
I don't know.
I think yes.
I don't know really, but and he's got a new song. It's beautiful.
Yeah,
I mean,
let's
Fonseca,
hear it.
Fonseca,
sing it for us. Come on, JD, sing for us.
What's the name of this song?
I'm gonna get JD drunk.
Joel is gonna play it.
I mean, halfway.
Joel can sing. He won't do it, but he can.
Really? I just don't remember. But I would be
singing a regular song.
Roberto Fonseca, baila mulata.
No.
Oh, he's not mic'd up right now.
Canto a la vida.
Canto a la vida, Fonseca.
Yeah. I have a signed, autographed CD from Fonseca.
Where did you get it?
Like, what's
from his father.
What's a CD?
It's a Betamax. He's got a Betamax.
I actually found...
VHS.
Very Colombian.
It's beautiful. diciendo que la noche apenas comenzó y ahora busco un motivo para poder decir.
Yeah, I like that.
Las
cosas
que no he dicho y que no vive. We're gonna add it. We're gonna add it to our
of the party at the Columbia show.
So I don't know what the rules are if we're allowed to play other people's music for like more than a clip. A
couple seconds. Yeah. We'll play the beginning of it.
So I don't know what the rules are with that.
Have you tried aguardiente? Of course you have. So this song in the last part of the song, actually in the chorus, they said that if you had good wine, don't storage it. I mean, drink it if you have good wine. But at the end, the last sentence so he repeats that through all the song. If you got good wine, don't storage, just drink it. And in the last sentence, they said, but the life has taught me that if you have no wine, just drink water. Aguardiente. So it's really good.
Like aguardiente is his, where it's at. His grandbaby is Colombian.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, awesome.
So
he plays soccer. Drinks aguardiente already.
The
it's
baby
crazy.
Doesn't drink aguardiente.
It does. Starting young.
It's a Colombian tradition. Of course it's tasted it by now.
What's guaranteed. His name?
All of my sons married Latinas.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. They're smart.
That's right.
No, yeah. I mean, they want to be tortured. What can
or
I
is it the Latinas exactly. want gringos?
Yeah. 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 I think it's equal. I think the gringos want Latinas and Latinas want gringos.
Well, I'm Latino and I'm stuck with a Latina too.
I like, you know, we
here
like
here in
punishment.
Miami, I'm talking
we're
about.
We're masochist.
Yeah. What's
here
that?
In Miami.
We're masochist. We love the Latin women to be tortured.
Yeah, masochist.
I heard there was like 4 women to each man here in Miami.
Like 7.
7.
7.
It's 7. It's an amazing, amazing city.
And Pockets is still
I don't know where they are.
Pockets is still. Because he doesn't live in Miami. He lives in Broward. He's messing up.
I don't know where they are.
Yeah, guys, whoever's listening, we have this wonderful young man. His name is Mike Pockets Riley. And we need to fix him up. So if you know anybody here in South Florida that's single and looking to mingle with, how old is Pockets?
I think he's 30, 28.
He's in his 30, early 30s.
I don't think he's 30.
The man's hardworking,
yeah.
Very responsible, easygoing, quiet. Likes to party.
Chivalrous.
From a great family.
Chivalrous. He holds the door and carries stuff for you.
He's from a great family. He has a wonderful brother. Yeah. And Mike is...
He has no problem with pot. I mean, it's a good thing. It's a good thing.
Yeah. If you don't like pot smell in your car, then he's not for you. But otherwise...
But he travels. Really... He went to Japan alone and stuff.
Yeah, he likes to travel. His very dependable, responsible. He's a great dancer.
Yeah, Edwin taught him well.
Yeah.
Edwin took him under his wing.
He loves Colombians.
So from Medellin. Just dial 305-499-9144 and ask for Pockets.
Call him.
No, we got to get this guy fixed up. Enough's enough already.
We're going to do The Bachelor with
Pockets.
By the way,
Mike, I sent him up on Tuesday.
Is he legal?
Yes, he's legal.
Okay.
He's legal.
Yeah. Okay. Un gringo.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
He has his nameplate in the front. When you leave, make sure you read it.
Okay. I saw one of the signs that said that I got fixer of everything.
We have his cell phone.
What's that?
We have his cell phone.
We do. Yeah.
Oh, Lord.
Good stuff. So we're going to ask you a bunch of random questions real quick. Just give us your first thought answers, all right?
Just like one word?
No. As much as just don't think about it too hard.
You can't think. Just fast.
Okay.
What, in your opinion, is the best sandwich?
Publix.
Pub sub. That's a good answer.
Meatball's
also a good answer. Meatball. What at the moment is your favorite flower?
Chrysanthemum.
Okay. What is the most underrated flower?
Chrysanthemum.
Yeah. What about the most overrated flower?
Rose.
Okay. If you had one superpower, what would it be?
When I do this, people shit themselves.
He said get naked, which is even funnier.
Why would you want people to shit themselves?
David wants them to get naked, and JD wants them to shit themselves. This is a great day.
It's the worst Marvel movie ever.
Yeah. Mike, I'm going to drive them home.
I don't think Marvel they can movie ever. So awesome.
He's the shittiest
superhero.
What would that superhero's name be?
The shitter.
That's from The Boys, right?
Shit.
Okay.
Oh man.
Have you ever asked someone for their autograph?
Oh yeah.
Can you name one? Or think
Andres Escobar. I mean, soccer players all over.
Yeah. Speaking of Escobar, you do that.
I did. Now I'm just asking for pictures. But,
can I ask you? I saw in the news recently about the hippopotamuses that are taking over the rivers.
Yeah,
because Escobar left them behind.
Well, he brought like 10, or actually 20.
He brought 20 hippos.
Male and female. Yeah.
Now we have millions.
That was more expensive than a Maserati.
Uh-huh.
And now we got thousands.
That's so
crazy. So what are they doing? Are they killing them?
Yep.
Yeah, some of them. They are some of
they are dangerous.
Yeah, they're really fucking dangerous.
They're one of the most dangerous
animals. That shit is crazy.
I really like hippos. That's like a weird.
I like them too.
In my sketchbook, I draw hippos a lot because I don't know. They're fat and they're chunky, but they're also so deadly that they look cuddly.
I wish you could hear the music that is playing in my head as I imagine you drawing your hippos.
Maybe that's a superhero hippo shit.
Well, that leads into our next question. What is the scariest animal?
The cockroach.
Okay.
The flying spider. Cockroach.
Oh yeah.
I've never seen a man scream until a cockroach starts flying.
Yeah.
Well, you think you got a corner and then it flies away?
Then it flies away.
Some of them.
In New York they don't fly.
They don't need to.
They fly here.
They're too heavy.
In Colombia they fly.
They're too heavy in New York.
Okay.
They're like that.
Yeah.
And we step in one and you see like a flam going there. In Colombia they're just like
they're skinny. They're skinny.
Just like you said how women outnumber men here, like the number of cockroaches to people in New York is crazy.
Oh yeah. And rats.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Every apartment I ever had was loaded. Nothing you can do about it.
I used to have an apartment in Boca where I had rats that would run through the wall, and like while you're sleeping in the night, you would through the walls behind your head.
Remember that movie, Joe's Apartment?
Is that why I got a
Joe's
bill apartment, to fix the wall?
Yeah. No.
Ryan was punching him.
No, when they moved out, like my security deposit didn't cover the damage.
Nobody ever gets their security deposit back.
No college kid gets their deposit back.
You know what it was? There was plenty of reasons why, but one specifically I remember, we had like a patio room and we had a beer pong table in the patio and we painted the beer pong table with glow in the dark paint. And then we also painted the ceiling fan and stuff out there with glow in the dark paint. So like all that stuff, we repainted it white afterwards. But like you can still kind of see it. Yeah. You can still see the glow of the dark afterwards.
Yeah, I remember getting like all these. I had to pay a lot of money. And why was I the only one on the hook with three roommates? Where were the other parents?
I don't think you paid for everything.
I paid for everything.
Nah, it was split. You got it. All right. What is your go-to way to relax?
Whiskey.
I play golf and yeah.
Golf and whiskey.
We call it whiskito.
Whiskito.
Yeah, I like it.
Yeah. I like scotch.
What kind of flowers do you want at your funeral?
Chrysanthemums.
Alma.
Alma.
White Alma.
Yeah. Alma.
It was at every other funeral. Might as well be at yours.
There we go. Pick a movie or TV character to have lunch with.
Steve Carell.
He's one of our number ones. Yeah.
Just Steve Carell or like a specific Steve Carell?
Steve Carell in the office.
40-year-old virgin?
The office. Yeah.
40-year-old virgin is a funny
one. I definitely want to meet the 40-year-old virgin.
It could be anybody, like living by a historic figure. Anybody
real, fake.
Petro.
Rigo.
Rigo.
Rigo? I don't know.
Yeah, the cyclist.
Oh.
Probably the cyclist, yeah.
Do you, are you also a cyclist?
No, actually, no. You want to meet this blind guy.
He knows who he
blind
wants
singer.
To meet.
Yeah.
Which one?
That's a real
Stevie
friendship.
Wonder?
No, the blind singer.
Making those face gestures.
Oh, Andrea Bocelli?
Yeah.
Like Mimi.
Huh? Andrea Bocelli?
Bocelli.
Bocelli.
Could be.
Bocelli.
That's a good one.
The opera singer. Yeah. Right? He's opera?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Sing it, girl.
What is your go-to drunk food? Or what are you going to eat after this podcast?
Hot dogs. Hot dogs.
Colombian
hot dogs. For me, hot dogs. No, actually, it's 7-Eleven hot dogs.
7-Eleven?
Yeah, no, man, you're not supposed to eat those.
Dude. No. Those are not supposed to ever be.
Those are for display only.
Talk about cucarachas.
Anybody who knows me.
You're lost.
No.
Who knows me know that the best restaurant in the United States is 7-Eleven.
Oh my God. Have you been to Bucky's?
He's still a college student. Nope. Okay. In his mind, he's still a college student.
No.
It's affordable and delicious at night.
Unless you're talking about slushies.
Chicharron.
With the chili and cheese.
Did you hear David's?
Oh, no, man.
Did you hear David's?
No.
Chicharron.
Ah,
chicharron.
Yeah.
Chicharron.
Yeah.
Okay, and last question. Could you suggest...
That's a good junk food, chicharron. Yeah.
Well, are you talking about like the
That's
pork rinds?
That's kind of junk.
No, because Edwin gets different chicharrón. Because you're talking like the pork rinds kind of, like the chips, Pero Edwin gets like little mini fries.
Tú estás hablando de como masitas, ¿no?
Those are chickens.
That's for me. It's a junk food.
Pork. No, he wants a traditional chicharrón.
He wants like
it's traditional, the traditional, the pork.
Yeah. The one that looks like a comb.
Yes, the whole full piece.
Me, me and Mimi tore up the chicharrón at the El Milagros open house.
We went to the open house and I was having a small breakfast in the morning, not a big one. Mike was having a small breakfast and the girls that were with us that we were going to the farm visits all had huge breakfast.
They eat,
soup. Eggs,
is this
bacon,
Bogota or
in Bogota? Yeah,
yeah, and because they have that. They had soup for the.
And me and Mike just did a little bit here, grazing here and there. Once we got to El Milagro, and they had this beautiful buffet, but they had all these different fruits and vegetables, and then chicharrones. Mm. And we were like, Mike
and
I,
little small, the little small one.
Yeah.
Mike
frito.
And I,
is soup as big in Colombia as it is in Ecuador?
Well, in Colombia, you get your soup. Yeah. And then your second.
Side, yeah.
Okay.
In Ecuador, their big meal of the day is lunch.
Yeah.
But they
in
have soup at every meal
that's
of
not the
day.
Case, yeah. Right?
Well, they have soup for breakfast.
Yeah,
soup
at every meal.
Oh, that's Bogota as well.
And then dinner is just a soup.
Yeah.
Bogota is another city in our, it's another country in our city.
Yeah. Okay. Could you suggest a guest for a future episode for this podcast?
From Miami?
No.
Anyway.
We go Zoom. When they can't come here.
We'll take the podcast to Colombia.
I would say Sofia Red. She's the most interesting woman in the industry, I think.
Where is she from?
Jardines.
From Bogota. She's from Jardines. She's one of the owners.
Jardines.
I would love to have her on.
That'd be amazing.
Okay.
Yeah.
I really thought he was going Sofia
Viagra.
She's
really smart.
Sofia Viagra.
No, but it's so interesting. She's a journalist.
I'm a fan of powerful women in the flower business. I'm a fan.
Yeah,
Sophia.
Thank you, Mike. Yeah, true.
And you?
No. Yeah,
I'm just a fan of women, but I like the flower girl, women too.
David, anybody you want to suggest?
I think Sophia also. We're very close to Sophia, and she's very smart.
Wow,
love to hear that.
You got to give Mimi Sophia's contact.
Sure. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Right now.
Sure.
We will make sure she doesn't listen to this episode, though.
No.
So I feel like
we can send
it to her.
I feel like she knows them already.
Yeah. So, gentlemen, how can someone get in contact with you if they want to learn a little more? Or maybe they want to go to the Pink Pony or play some golf. How can they get in contact?
Just see us in our social media, Deliflor Americas, and also if you need anything, I'm not going to give fun numbers or anything, but if you go on
all
Google,
the people has it.
Deliflor Americas, and you
what's your email?
It's on the website.
It's jd.lequona@deliflor.com, and David is
david.marin@deliflor.com.
If you go to the About Us on the website, their emails are on there too. That's awesome.
But if you don't have my contact by now, I just don't need you. I'm just kidding.
You heard it first here. If you don't have his contact, he does not like you.
But I was just kidding because they gave me a lot of scotch.
Yeah, no.
It's my fault, guys. I'm sorry.
It worked, though. It went well.
Yeah, it went well.
Yeah, it killed that bottle.
Yeah. It was empty to begin with.
Yeah. It was half.
It was empty.
They were both half full.
It's amazing they've lasted this long. Just so. All right, so we're good. We didn't miss anything.
No, this has been a fun episode. Very funny too.
We have fun.
I would like
guys.
To thank you for coming, and I also want to thank you for your innovation and for your drive. And I think it's really good for business because as you innovate, your competitors have to try to keep up with you, and they need to innovate. And then all of a sudden, there's all this
you
new
make
shit
the industry
coming into
better that way.
Yeah.
Good job, guys. Keep going.
Right back at you.
But
guys.
Once you get up to thank the top, your job gets harder.
Yeah. That's what I tell David.
That's the biggest challenge.
It's easy to be a follower, to be, I know what these guys are doing, so I'm going behind. But then when you have to create or the trend or what to do.
That's the challenge.
Yeah.
Every day you have the passion.
to keep doing.
And you experience it every day. I mean, you guys have to experience
it. Well, I'm a believer that everyone has their moment.
Yeah.
Right? It could take you a year, it could take you 100 years, but everyone has their moment. And once you have your moment, you want to be there and you need to stay there. And it's hard work. Yeah. Hard work, because everybody's coming for you. Right?
So yeah, you're totally right. Yeah.
So, but thank you for all that you're doing for the industry. It's really good. And thank you also for being so involved in the industry organizations. I'm just beginning after all these years to try to be involved in some stuff. Yeah. Fern as well, Ryan, Mimi's always been involved, but
Mimi knows everybody.
It takes a village, right? It takes a lot of people to, and our industry is kind of shrinking. So it's important.
Yeah.
So thank you.
And we're getting old.
Yeah, you're getting old.
Speak for yourself. No. Yeah, I'm getting younger.
No, I mean,
I'm still 25.
There's not like new people.
There is. No. There's gonna be new people.
It's
but
coming,
you know what's
coming.
Most important is that you continue to do what you did for Colombia and what you're doing for the world with the sustainability, because that's what's gonna bring people into our industry. If we continue to talk about topics that are interesting to them, and believe it or not, this is one of those things that really can bring and attract a lot of new people to you.
You're
and
gonna like, see it at SAF no, next
people
gen.
Is coming. We need to understand the new people.
Yeah,
we need to
that's a whole other thing.
Things for the new
that's
people.
Another thing Business that we're gonna changed. Learn. We all have to learn. We all have to adjust to it, but it's gonna happen. And this industry is gonna get better. And you guys have to protect that beautiful land, because
Business
Colombia
have to adapt
is,
to the new people. Yeah.
Do you have any letters?
Letters.
Yeah.
AAF.
AIFD,
ABC, DEFG. No?
Yeah. Me neither.
I got this.
Need some letters.
We're working on letters.
You gotta get some letters.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. Well, but actually, my badges are also like.
Exactly. Yeah. Ah.
You pay for it.
You pay for that. Yeah, I pay for all the ribbons.
Love it.
It's
Love
part
it.
Of your alma.
Oh, yeah.
We're downsizing at home, and I have this collection of badges from shows for like the past
you
20
want
years.
Badges?
I have to get rid of it.
They collect all the badges. Yeah. It has like I don't know, 1,000 badges. Like,
I want to know where do you guys have all the SAF ribbons?
In my office?
In your office?
We have in the office. Yeah. In a wall.
Wow.
Well, like actually, we have like a kind of wall of fame with all the ribbons.
Nice. No, but wait. I mean, we have this big frame. It's like a painting, but it's not. It says that we won in best in show, best in class, blue, red ribbon and blue ribbon. And the years. That's it.
So but you just
all
added
the actual ribbons, I have them in my office.
You should make a suit with them.
I'm surprised you guys in Holland don't make you send it to them. Let you keep them.
No, because that's Deliflor Americas.
Belong to us.
Okay. That's all your hard work. Yeah.
No, they do won the Golden Tulip last year. Mm. And they are pushing. Well, they're not pushing. They entered this new variety called Commander to participate this year.
You got to go to Chrysanthemum Week this year.
Yeah, when is it? You gotta go. We're working on something.
It's gonna be in the week 35th.
That's August 26th till 30th.
Is it open to anybody?
Yeah.
So anybody who wants to go to that, that's
anybody in the
industry.
Of course. Yeah. Anybody in the industry.
Cool. I know, but we're working something with them for that.
So what is it like? Shuttles that take you from one breeder to the other?
No,
do you guys work together to get people around?
It's drivers. We got like 20 drivers that go from every breeder to another.
But we cooperate all together.
You guys
all the breeders cooperate together to bring the clients from Ecuador, from Bogota.
That's good. You guys are working for a greater good together. That's awesome.
Yeah. No one is bigger than all together.
Yeah, that's right.
Hell yeah.
Okay, Fern, take us out.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this has been another amazing episode of Two Fat Guys Talking Flowers. Thank you to our guests, David Marine, JD Lacuna, Joel, Mimi, Ryan, myself, Mike. Thank you guys for listening. Have a great day.